We have been taking time to examine and study the gifts of the Holy Spirit, and we are going to continue doing that this morning. So let's talk about tongues, diversities of tongues. What's the definition? I mean, what definition could we give to this? It's the supernatural ability to speak in languages of men or of angels. All believers can speak in tongues, Mark 16:17. Now, when you speak in tongues, according to Acts 2:11, you're declaring the wonderful works of God. You can praise and extol and magnify God in tongues. Tongues is a manifestation of the Spirit, and so it gives evidence to the presence and the working of the Holy Spirit. 1 Corinthians 13:1, when you're speaking in tongues, you could be speaking in earthly languages or heavenly languages, tongues of men or of angels. But what does this all this serve? Why would God want you and me to speak in languages which we haven't learned, which we don't understand? Here are some benefits. The Bible says in 1 Corinthians 14:2 that when we speak in tongues, we are praying mysteries. It says in 1 Corinthians 14:4 that when you're praying in tongues, it brings edification. That is, it brings inner strength. It's like your spiritual gym God gives you. It says, okay, in the natural, you want to build up strength. You know where you go. You go to your gym. You work out. Now, in the spiritual, you want to build strength. This is what you do. Pray in tongues. When you pray in tongues, you're making intercession for the saints, Romans 8:26. When you pray in tongues, you're praying according to the will of God, Romans 8:27. When you're praying in tongues, you will never miss it because the prayer is inspired by the Holy Spirit. When you pray with the Spirit, Jude says in Jude 1:20, you're building yourself up on your faith. Praying in the Spirit enables you to stay in the love of God. Praying in tongues is part of our spiritual armor. And for some of us, praying in tongues can be a part of our gift, a calling in the body, especially those who are called to be intercessors and really minister that way. I would encourage all of us to pray in tongues a lot. Now, for those of us who don't pray in tongues, I want to encourage you to do that. How do you do it? Just go home, say, Lord Jesus, baptize me with your Holy Spirit. Fill me with the Holy Spirit. God, I want to speak in tongues because this is available to all believers. And then you take a step of faith and it's going to happen. The interpretation of tongues. Interpretation is simply the supernatural ability to interpret, give the meaning of a message that has been given in tongues. Here's how interpretation kicks in your personal prayer life. That as you're praying in tongues, and there are times when you say, Holy Spirit, help me understand what I'm praying. And the Holy Spirit begins to give you the sense of what you are praying. Now, if you're doing it in public, so if I were to speak to you and speak a message in tongues, then I need to interpret it. That interpretation is equivalent to prophecy, and it also happens in a very similar way. So let's talk about the gift of prophecy. Prophecy is simply God speaking through man to man. Prophecy is inspired utterance. That means you're not preparing the message. It's a message from God given to you at that moment, and you're delivering it to somebody. 1 Corinthians 14:3 says, he who prophesies speaks edification, exhortation, comfort. Edification means to build up. You're saying something that will build the person up, not tear them down. Build them. Edification. Exhortation is to encourage and comfort. They need to be soothed, comforted, feel loved, feel cared for in a certain moment. How does prophecy help people? One, it could bring encouragement. It can motivate someone into action in a specific area. It can reveal the potential that God has placed in people's lives. It can bring confirmation what God has been speaking to someone. It can inspire prayer for a particular matter in an individual. It can bring guidance and direction into people's lives. It can bring correction. It also can bring revelation of scripture from the mind of God. How do you prophesy? Very simple. Three simple steps I want to give you for you to get started. Pray, perceive, prophesy. A few thoughts here on how to release prophecy before we close here is that there are many ways to express prophecy. It doesn't always have to be spoken. Speaking is one way. But you can write it. Some people can paint it. Some people can draw it. Some people can sing it. Some people may act it out. There are many ways to express an inspired message that God puts in your heart. Okay? Simplest and easiest, of course, is just to say it. You know, this is what God is saying. This is what I feel God is saying. Simplest. The timing of when you deliver the message is in your control. Allow yourself to be judged. The Bible tells us that we must test all things and hold on to what is good. So all prophecy must be judged. Don't be too hasty to say, thus says the Lord. Remember, we know in part and we prophesy in part, 1 Corinthians 39. Don't try to be a fortune teller. Lastly, don't practice witchcraft.